So this is the initial startup of the steam humidifier. It goes through a number of trials, sorting out the hardness of the water.
Well, see, it's slowly putting more and more current. It's literally two probes sticking down into the tank of water. There's steam being introduced into the duct system.
Nice.
Yeah.
Hi, welcome back. I am Andrea. This is my dad. He is here as a dad in my basement, and he just installed a steam humidifier. So we thought it'd be interesting to share with you how it works and how it's different than other whole house humidifiers and why I'm super excited about it.
Well, the steam humidifier is a whole nother breed of appliance. It truly is an appliance. It's a moisture making machine. It's a small boiler. And so it requires a little more work than your typical humidifier. One being it's an electric boiler. It is a boiler. That's the hardest part many times is just getting an electrical circuit to the humidifier. So it requires a 20 amp, 240 volt circuit. You'll kind of see up here, you actually had a circuit stubbed in for future use, which was really great. We basically had to run this 20 amp circuit all the way down and
where
underneath.
Is it? It's right here? Or
yes, this is the 20 amp circuit right here. Okay. And it is going to, we mounted the humidifier under the stairs. May look kind of strange, but you can kind of see that there's plenty of room, lots of serviceability around it.
Here is my water heater furnace on this side.
Right.
And this is an under the stairs situation, and
right,
you just put it on the back side on its own little mm-hmm. wall back here.
Put a plywood up on the wall there so we had a nice secure place to mount it. Ran our water to it. It requires water, so we've got a water line run to it. And then the outlet is that black pipe coming off the top. So when it is calling for humidity, it is hot with steam.
Okay.
We literally inject steam into the supply plenum. You can kind of look up through here. This pipe right here is the steam line that's going into the plenum up there. You can hear the, remember we installed the variable drive motor in this furnace. And so we've got the furnace going on a slow circulation mode. And so it's circulating air throughout the house, and we will inject steam into the air and spread it throughout the house. This line gets hot, so we insulated it. It's kind of a long line, but well within the guidelines of what we can do.
Do you want to explain kind of the guts of the steam humidifier?
Here's the internals of the humidifier. We've run our circuit here. Now this looks like a typical light switch, but it's actually a double pole switch. This is a 240 volt switch, and we can kill the power to the humidifier. You'll see inside the humidifier is this canister. It's really kind of fun to watch. You know, when we first turned it on, we were kind of watching it. It has a probe that goes down into the water and two electrical probes. We are literally boiling water inside this, what looks like a plastic canister, but we will boil water inside here, and it will constantly adjust itself for the hardness of your water. So it takes several days for it to really kind of figure out what's it going to take to boil water. To optimize this canister, it keeps the water as low as possible and still boil. As residue collects on the sensors, it will actually raise the water level as it goes. But right now it's kind of staying right at this midpoint. But it literally, when we call for humidity upstairs, we have a canister boiling water, and you saw it boiling when we first turned it on. It's pretty cool. It's like having a pot on the stove.
Right.
Yeah, and then immediately injecting it into the airflow upstairs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Cool.
So we've got a drain. It takes a sizable drain because it does flush water. It's constantly finding the optimum water level, so it will drain water. Now we have hot water in this, so we don't want to drain hot water. So it will actually mix cold water and make it so we can just drain it through a plastic tube. But you can kind of follow it all the way around, and it kind of helps having it secured to the floor drain. You kind of follow this clear tube
mm-hmm.
all the way around. You can kind of see where
it's hooked down there.
I put a 90 degree fitting on the end of it so it doesn't end up out on the surface of the floor there. That's all there is to it. These things are extremely trouble free. This canister, depending on the hardness of your water, will need to be replaced. And it can be as often as annually. Mine at my house, you know, I've got a water softener and a water filter. You know, mine lasts several years at my home. So it really just kind of depends on the water. That's all there is to it.
Thanks, Dad.
Mm-hmm.